Hey everyone, Tijmen here, and in this video I will demonstrate a concise alternative to the classic if-else statement and the new match case statement that has been introduced in Python 3.10. The approach uses a dictionary to attain a conditional with less and arguably more readable code. While it won't be a replacement for each and every if-else or match case statement in your code, it certainly is useful in plenty of situations. The only drawback is that it comes at the cost of a minor decrease in runtime, which is addressed later on in this video. Say we want to create a function that takes a number as argument, then validates whether this number corresponds to a month, and if it does, returns the full name of that particular month. If the provided argument is not a valid month index, we return a string that indicates that the input is invalid. If we were to use an if-else statement, the function would look something like this. Another approach would be to use the recently released match case statement, which is, at least to my liking, already a slight improvement in terms of code clarity. But what you're really here for is see how you can implement such a conditional using a dictionary, resulting in an even more readable and concise function block. Step 1 is to return a dictionary. We use the index of the months as keys and the corresponding names as value. Subsequently, we use the get method to obtain the name of the month that actually belongs to the number that we provided as function argument. The great thing about this method is that we can also specify a default return value for when the requested key is not part of the dictionary. In our case, this is the string, not a month. Now, let's see this snippet in action. First, we obtain the index of the current month using Python's built-in date module. At the time of recording this video, it is November, so the variable month index equals 11. If we pass the variable to our function, we see that the default value is returned because November is not yet included in our dictionary. So let's add it. If we run our code again, we see that the function indeed returns November. As promised, I want to end this video with a quick speed comparison. If we call the function that I just illustrated a million times for every month, our total runtime is about 10 seconds. This is around 3.5 seconds when using if-elif-else statements, and also around 3.5 seconds using the new match case statement. While our dictionary conditional has the least best performance, it is important to understand where this difference comes from. Because we define our dictionary within the month function, it has to be constructed once for every function call, which is rather inefficient. If we instead define the dictionary outside the function and rerun the experiment, we achieve the fastest runtime, which is around 2.5 seconds. What suits you best in terms of code clarity and runtime is of course up to you. You will know what is more important for your specific project. Consider this method as just another tool in your toolbox that is sometimes right for the job and sometimes it is not. Anyway, that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful and see you at the next one.